Thank you. They're great. They're sensational. They rock, man. And some time ago, they were it. But they fell apart for some reason. We'll talk about that. But they are back together. And now they are still rocking like no tomorrow. Put your hands together and welcome the great group, Wutah.
Thank you, man. Yeah.
Wutah in the house. Give it up. Welcome, folks. Welcome.
Thank you, Daddy.
First of the course, when we come back, the show will begin. Stick around, folks. Wutah in the house. We'll be right back.
It's gonna get sweeter than Guinea Pie. It's the KSM Show.
The KSM Show.
Okay, we're back. And I think this is a free year. Yeah, I always say a free and all Rasta, no. And then Kobe has a... What's your style?
Kobe style.
Okay. welcome, man. It's good to have you here, man.
Thanks, Dad.
I have been a die-hard Wutah fan, man. You know, when I hear, it does something to me, you know. Wow. So I don't want to dwell on this, man, but you guys, you something happened and you split for a while.
Yes, we had to part ways at a certain juncture.
Why?
But for some reason, we've decided to put that behind us. So we barely talk about
it. So you don't talk about it. I respect that.
Thank you.
Sometimes you don't want to dwell on the past. That's it. So I respect that.
Thank you. That if you want a wound to die, you have to quit touching it.
I like that.
Yeah,
I like that. Okay. But the important thing is that you are back.
Definitely. Yes.
Fantastic. Show them some love one more time. Great. So let me start with you, Efriye.
Yes, Daddy.
Yeah, because you are closer to me. Mm-hmm. How is the rejuvenation of Wutah?
I think it's been more than we expected.
Really?
The love, you know, the love the fans have shown us, the media. Like you, Daddy, yourself, KSM. I'm a big fan, huge fan. The Saga of the Returnee, I remember.
Oh, my God. Oh, my goodness.
Yeah, so the love has been great. It's as if we never left.
Mm-hmm.
Yes,
mm-hmm.
And I think every good thing deserves a good favor in return. So, in return, we also promise fulfilling our promise to deliver, give them the best.
Fantastic.
Musically.
Fantastic.
So
fantastic.
That's what we've been up to, been doing so far.
Okay. And your reaction to the new Wutah?
Well, I think that it's priceless because, for me, I say that God works in mysterious ways that we cannot explain, and He manifests through man. So when you see that people, after 7 to 8 years, and then we come back and they receive us, and the song is number one for 3 weeks, going to 4 weeks, what more can you say about that?
You know, it's
just amazing. It's
fantastic.
Like, words cannot describe.
That's fantastic. Let me, Fred, give me a little bit about growing up.
Yeah, growing up, I grew up in Mamprobi, a suburb of Accra.
Okay.
Yeah.
Your parents?
I'm an Akan. I'm actually from Begro in the Eastern region. Yes. I come from Begro. Mi area kotoko nana. Nana area kotoko.
I see.
Greetings, Nana. Yes. My father is Fostose Puku. Yes. I grew up in Mamprobi, a suburb of Accra, like I said earlier. I had my basic education at St. Mary's Preparatory School. I later on went to Accra High School, and then later I studied procurement at Accra Polytechnic.
I see.
And then I'm doing music now. Music-wise, I think the influence was big. I lived in a compound house of about 40 rooms, so you can imagine people with different kind of taste and preference when it comes to music. One man in particular who influenced me, and I keep mentioning his name, we used to call him Edo. Hedo is a Ga phrase to say it's hot.
Yeah.
Yes. And he was a lover of music. I think I haven't seen his kind since I left that area. Mm. Because he had all the collections. Mm. Talk of, you know, from all genres, talk of high life, talk of R&B, talk of reggae. And I remember every day, it was like a religion, a routine.
And that influenced you?
Yes, he would turn on the radio from A to Z o'clock. Everyone would complain in the house. So I grew up and I realized I was so versatile. I could function almost everywhere. So I sat one day and asked, where from this? Then I realized that man's back in the day, disturbance we tagged,
was what made me, subconsciously.
Wow. I was just, these things were embedded here. So I think that's a little thing about me growing up in music. Mm-hmm. So I met Kobe along the line. I think my first appearance on TV was with Azik Izzah, Video Vibes in 95. With one Rebecca Jan. I don't know if she still sing. And from there, we've been through a series of competitions, and mm-hmm. we're here today.
Fantastic, fantastic. And your background?
Well, mine is quite different because I was born in Adaraka. And, you know, at that time, my mom was a single parent, so we kept moving and moving and moving. So we moved to Osu, to Abeka, to La Paz, to Fadama, to Mampubi, to Kashiman.
Wow.
It was just round to Mampubi and then to Dansoman. And then finally at Abokubi, you know, in between then I've been traveling in and out too as well. But well, I met my brother when I was in Mampubi. That was around JSS 1. Mm-hmm. You know, we were like quite young. And his senior brother, Foster Osepoku, was our classes teacher. And Dr. Foster.
consultant, to be precise.
You see, you know, at the time, he was the smartest in the neighborhood. So when I got to the neighborhood, I asked where I could do extra classes. So,
and this
story is quite interesting. You know, like I was told that he was the smartest in mm-hmm. the neighborhood, so I could go to the extra classes at his place. So I started, and I went for like a week, and I came back to tell my mom, well, you know, what he's teaching me, I already know, so there was no point going. So I stopped, and he didn't know why I stopped. So he came after a week to come and ask why I stopped. And then my mom told him that, oh, your boy, he said, he knows he's there, so let him be. And then he said, oh, I know the problem. He knows that the people that I was learning with at the time were not at, you know, like, in quotes, mother. Mm-hmm. So he said, I'll find you one killer. And then we will do. And then I was there one day and they brought some long hair. And there was my brother.
Really?
Yeah. So it was just the two of us in the class.
Wow.
Whenever he teaches, he gives like a work. He gives 30 minutes and 5 minutes. We are done and we are talking about something different. And then he came and he's like, but you guys, when I give you work, you are talking. I said, like, okay, we are finished. And he checks and it's clean, clean. And he said, look, me, I don't know what to teach you guys. I give you, you can't stop. And we stopped.
Wow.
And then from there, we realized that we had so much in common because we played football together, we sang together, acrobats, all dancing, so many things we were doing together. So that was how far. But my music background came from my mom because my mom used to sing in church. So when I was in Abeka Christian Church, I used to be the junior choir leader.
You know, I see.
Singing in there. So
I see.
That's how come I developed the music.
So yours was from, the, you know.
From, yeah.
Yeah, your mom's influence, generic, yeah, choir.
Yeah.
And you, that noisy neighbor.
Noisy neighbor.
But at the end of it, both elements introduced you to some forms of music.
Yeah.
So between the two of you, when did it click? That you should do something together musically?
I think that there was this there was one guy called Abuba. He was always finding problem for us.
Serious problem.
You know, when we meet, we all like friends. When we meet, my brother will sing and I will sing, and when I'm not there, he will come and tell my brother, oh, Kobe can sing better than you. What you are doing there, me, I don't see. So whenever I meet him, he wants to prove to me that and me, I also want to prove to him, and when I'm with him, he tell me, you, what you are doing, every year is doing better than what you are doing.
Wow.
You know, so along the line, when we had to join forces to do the Nescafe, I realized that there was no better person to join, you know, force with than him. So then, like, okay, we were doing songs together before the competition, and that's how come we had to do it. So we had a couple of songs way back. Mm-hmm. We used to do some performances in school, secondary school, and all of that. Mm. And then the Nescafe came into
me. Wow.
I tell people that we went to see Book Back like 2005.
And
1999. Around that time.
Yes.
And we told them that our album was ready. So we, by then we were like,
yeah, SS,
like 14, 13. We had songs. Even Big Dream was a song that was written around.
Around then?
That yes.
Really?
Yeah. I wrote Big Dreams, SS1. Yes.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow. Yeah.
And.
No. And how long from the time you wrote it till the time it became such a...
10 years plus.
Yes, I think, yeah, after 10 years, that big dream was realized.
Wow. But the dream was realized.
Yes, it was. It was. It materialized, you know.
That was big. Big Dreams was big.
Yes.
Wow. Can you do a duet?
Yeah.
Big
Dreams? Yeah.
Some koe wambi.
Big dreams, all I can see, sometimes I try to make them true. Big dreams,
oh Lord,
all I can see. Sometimes I try,
sometimes I try
to make them true.
That's a lot, man. Oh wow, it's amazing, man. Like, thank you. So you wrote that far back, and it took about 10 years.
Yes.
Wow.
There was this man called Mr. Quay, and he lived in a compound house with his grandmother, mother, like it was a whole big house. And every afternoon he would come and call us that he would produce us, so we should come and sing. And then he would line up all the oldies in the house and we'd sing.
Yeah, memories.
And in your mind you were singing for potential producer.
You know. But it's funny, we met at the top. Mm-hmm. We have a concert coming up in Canada in October, and this same man happens to be the organizer.
Oh, really?
So you see, from there we met at the top.
Really?
Again.
Really?
Yes.
Really? That's fascinating. Wow. So what's your pet dream now? You know, you guys are back together in terms of the music as an industry. Where you guys fit in? What is it that?
Yeah, I think our music now, our popular music. I always call it our music. High life has been on the decline lately. It's been marginalized. Mm. It hasn't really gotten the recognition it needs as compared to back in the day. You know, we had big international record labels coming in to produce the likes of Pat Thomas, those CBSs. You know, back then the industry was rich and was so attractive. So every musician's dream was to venture into that particular avenue. But unfortunately, there's been a disconnect because of the influx of these foreign genres. Now we say dancehall, we say Afrobeat. Afrobeats came from High Life. Mm-hmm. It's a cousin of High Life. Yes, so I think there's so much work to do.
Just were bringing back the traditional high life.
We can't, you know, society isn't static.
Yeah, it moves on.
People don't change though, but we adapt to those changes around us, and these changes will occur. Unfortunately, we change completely sometimes, which is so bad. And the people without a past have no future. I can say the bottle of Coke we've been enjoying will have the same taste forever, though the bottle may change at a point. So if we are to see our high life somewhere, I think, yes, certain elements have changed, but the basic, you know, the fundamental stuff shouldn't change. We need to make it attractive to the younger musician. And trust me, these days, the musician today is so versatile. And place him in any unit, he or she can function. So if I can do reggae, and I can do high life, and high life is not attractive and it doesn't pay like reggae does,
mm-hmm.
I'll definitely venture.
Yeah.
Yes, go in that direction. And that kills our industry. High life to us is like the 12-bar blues to the black Americans in America. You know, it's you can never do away with it. That's why you hear some of these dancehall songs, and you know these are sea shanties being sung. And these sea shanties fall under, you know, that big high life tree. Asafube sone, enyanzo obeja, I skiba, skikiba, skikiba, aloga. You know, these are all sea shanties these fishermen sing when you go to Choco and other coastal lines. You see, so it's very sickening to see our very, in fact, the oldest and most popular dance music declining, and nobody is doing anything about it. The other side is the younger generation didn't really get to listen to some of the artists
we have. Didn't grow up on.
Exactly.
Yeah.
The Pat Thomases, the A.B. Krenzels. Mikkei, and you know, pam, pam. We used to even play the beats in the song, horns. Pam, 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 pam. These things were things we easily played around. But now, you don't hear them anymore. There's been that disconnect. And we need to bridge the gap. So my little girl at home, mommy, when she listens to High Life, will know that I don't have to be a fan of hip-hop to show that I'm this or I'm that. We should be proud of our own. And going forward, I think one key thing is to reintroduce music back into the schools. Yes. That way, an artist, or sorry, a student gets to learn how to play at least an instrument. And daddy, trust me, if we should implement this, the least we should expect from such a project is a better musician who can be employed at any stage in life, especially with all these new churches springing up all over. The demand for instrumentalists is so high now. So after GSS, if you have to wait home for 1 year to go back to SHS, I think that time you can use it profitably. So this is our main bane now.
That's your focus now.
That's my focus. So we're here. If you listen to our new joint, Bunya, we try to go back and bring some of the old elements, because Afrobeat has been, in fact, it's all over now, dancehall Afrobeat, and Afrobeat is from High Life, like I keep saying. So we try to introduce some of the elements like the cowbell, like the cross fingering, the guitar plucking, you know, all these things were there, now they're no more.
Yeah.
So we try to fuse all of them. Back. And
I think it's a good point to take a quick break and take a look at this video. And it's Bronya?
Bronya.
Yes. Let's take a look at this video. Fantastic. So this is like a fusion. This is what you are talking about, Kobe?
High life.
Yeah. Bringing back the...
Yeah, as you can see, that I mean, the sound... It's refreshing, you know, it bridges the gap between the old and the new, and it's the, as you can see in the video, the oldies are dancing to it, and the youngsters are also, you know, doing their own thing with it.
So you want to break that gap
exactly.
Now, so that both elements can enjoy.
Exactly.
Fantastic. And
because of the way we were brought up, or the way we still bring up our kids, it's so easy, it's not difficult at all. We go to church, and what do we sing? Dana, see, Dana. These are our high life melodies we're singing. So, unconsciously, the child actually picks up those tunes. And one day, bringing them out shouldn't be a problem. You just need something to kickstart it. And then we're good to go. And that's the magic Bronya did. So, you see my grandmom jump into it, and my daughter jump into it as well.
Fantastic. So, in wrapping up, I have just like a few seconds. Your concluding words. Let me start with you, Kobe.
Yeah. Well, it's been nice being with you. You know, I would always want to come back here over and over again. The last time we had to sing together, so we make sure we do that before we leave.
Okay.
But I just want to say thank you to every Ghanaian who has supported us, both local and foreign, all music lovers who love Wutah. And please reach out to us on our social medias.
Okay, guys. Well, before you leave, I want you to sing before you leave. But before you sing, is there a number we can contact you? Anybody out there who's looking to get you guys, to engage you guys? Where can they reach you?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, you can reach us directly on our manager's number on 0268788800.
Okay.
Yeah.
0268788800. And the number is on your screen right now. So you can call them, and that's the manager's number.
We can promise them.
So let's go out with another duet.
Brunya.
Okay.
Brunya. We're all going to do it together.
Yeah, baby. I like the way you shake body. I get money. And then you marry my young Cody. I swear while I say, who did me cheer, you know, go sorry. Forget your worry. I they come to spend so lash your money.
Okay, I said, go.
Go. Yeah, brother, I am Jem, Brunya. Ah, oh, yeah, brother, I am Jem, Brunya.
Sing along, sing along, sing along.
Hey, yeah, brother,
yeah, brother, yeah, bro.
Yeah, yeah.
Ah, oh, yeah, brother, I am Jem, Brunya.
Show some love, man. Wutah in the house.
and I can't go back. You're really back. Thanks, and having you number one after your long break means that
we are here to stay.
You are here to stay.
Thanks, Daddy.
Show the song one more time. And stick around. We'll be right back.
If you're having as much fun as I am, stay tuned. If you're not, you need deliverance. We'll be right back.